Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to continue with our OneDrive series. And I would like to do a lesson today that's a little bit different than what we normally do. I am going to just talk about the comparison between OneDrive and SharePoint, because it can get really confusing when to use which file sharing service. So I created a chart here that goes through each of the benefits of using OneDrive versus using SharePoint. So hopefully you can follow along with me today and come away from this knowing a little bit more about the strengths of each file sharing service. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description. So let's look at the first task. The first task is, what is your default sharing mode? Well, with OneDrive, your default sharing mode is a private sharing mode, whereas with SharePoint, your default sharing mode is a shared mode. So what that means is that when I upload a file to OneDrive, by default, it is just my file. It's not shared with anyone else by default. I can share that file with other people, but just in the initial upload process, it's just me. I can open the file, I can upload it to OneDrive, and then use it from different devices in different places. And no one else can, unless I specifically go out and assign those permissions to that person. SharePoint, on the other hand, has a team in mind. So SharePoint, when you upload a file by default, has whoever has permissions to that file location by default for the file that is uploaded. So you can see there, hopefully, that OneDrive is more private and SharePoint is more shared just by default. But you can change those settings, but just that's what their default is. Next, let's go over concurrent users. Concurrent users is when you have more than one user in a file at a time. Both OneDrive and SharePoint will let you use more than one user in it at a time, and you can see those changes being made in real time. The third task is notification of changes. If you've ever been out on your OneDrive and you have a shared file, you don't get a quick notification that the file has been changed. But if you're on SharePoint and you're sharing a file, and this is a team file, you do get a notification that that file has been changed. So if I've uploaded a shared file to SharePoint and then someone downloads it and is working with it, I get an automatic email that that person is working on that file, whereas I don't get that inside of OneDrive. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. The next task, and we talked about this in the introduction to OneDrive, is the version history. Both OneDrive and SharePoint do have version history, but the version history of SharePoint is just a little more robust because it is dealing with changes made by multiple users at multiple times. So they both do allow for version history. One is a little bit stronger than the other. The next element I would like to look at is the permissions. In OneDrive, the permissions are assigned by individual document or individual file that is uploaded to OneDrive, whereas on SharePoint, the permissions are assigned by the group. So it's a little less maintenance because on SharePoint, you only have to manage permissions by the group, whereas on OneDrive, you have to manage those permissions by every file that you upload into SharePoint. And then for mobile access, you are able to access your OneDrive files remotely on any other device that you would like to use that file on. And also on SharePoint, you have mobile access as well. So those are pretty equal across the board. And the same thing with device syncing. All of your devices can sync to OneDrive and all of your devices can sync to SharePoint. So the general rule of the process of OneDrive and SharePoint is that you start with a private file inside of OneDrive. You work on that file and you get it to be exactly what you want it to be before you go out and share it with everyone else. And then once you've worked out all of the nuances of your file, then you can upload it over to SharePoint and then everyone can have access to the file and start making the changes that you require. So it's not always in either or OneDrive, SharePoint. A lot of times it is start in OneDrive, end in SharePoint. And then another question that arises with this is, what about Microsoft Teams? Well, Microsoft Teams would be more on the side of SharePoint. When using Teams and using your files, it's pretty much just like SharePoint. everyone on the team has access. You can make those concurrent changes. It works a lot. Like if you've used Google Docs before, you can see the other person making the changes to the document at the same time. So I would just put Microsoft Teams in the same category as SharePoint. Sure, there's a few little nuances there, but just think of it that way. Start in OneDrive, end in SharePoint or Teams. So hopefully that gives you a quick overview of the different strengths of the different services. And I hope that it's broadened your mind a little bit more to think about both of those applications. Hope you learned something new today and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.